Experiencing great buildings has often been compared to hearing a symphony. Almost 50 years ago, Jørn Utzon won an international competition to design the Sydney Opera House. Now, in 2004, he has returned to his master project and designed what will be the first Utzon interior. The centerpiece of this interior will be a tapestry designed by the architect himself. Homage to Carl Philipp Emanuel Bach.
The tapestry, the inspiration for the tapestry came from the thought that a building should be decorated by something that reflected its use. The thought to do something which would take its inspirational point in music has been with him for a long time.
After many different discussions, have found a way to express music in a picture.
So the source of inspiration for him was the Hamburgische Symphony of Carl Philipp Emanuel Bach.
Which is a piece of music with a basic rhythm with a darker instrument. And at the same time, you have the vivid play of the solo instrument.
The other source of inspiration for the tapestry was a painting by Raphael titled The Procession to Calvary.
And this processional movement triggered his basic idea for the tapestry. And then he combined it with the notion of music, so his procession had the rhythm of the music.
Lynn Utzon chose the Victorian Tapestry Workshop as the best place to weave the tapestry. The highly skilled artist weavers have a reputation for translating artists' work to tapestry. The starting point for the workshop was a large colour photocopy of Utzon's collage design. Samples were made as a guide to the colour and the texture of the tapestry. In particular, they wanted to incorporate the torn edges of the collage into the tapestry design. It was up to Grigina Bleger, director of the workshop, to take these samples to Denmark to meet Jørn Utzon and his daughter Lynn and discuss the palette and the interpretation of the artwork to tapestry. With the first week of weaving now underway, a cartoon made from the original artwork is hung behind the loom. This has been enlarged to the size of the tapestry, and the weavers will ink the design onto the warps as a guide for their weaving. All of the 21 colours of Australian wool and cotton that have gone into the tapestry were dyed here at the workshop, with the exception of the gold. That proved to be a challenge.
After initial discussion with Jørn Utzon, we knew that all the colours were right except the gold. So when I came back, we started to search for the perfect gold.
The original samples taken to Denmark were rejected. He wanted a more lively, metallic look. Finally, the perfect gold was found, and bobbins were made up which consisted of 7 threads of gold to 1 strand of cotton, which produced the effect Jørn Utzon was looking for.
That really tells something about him as an artist, because we thought it was maybe too bright, maybe not sophisticated enough, yet when we did with almost this 1 square meter of gold, it looks stunning.
The weavers at the Victorian Tapestry Workshop work in the traditional Gobelin method, dating back to the 14th century. The Utzon tapestry will use 4,500 kilometres of wool and weigh 120 kilograms. It will be so large, more than 14 metres long by 2.5 metres high, that it needs to be woven on its side. Last day, the final hitches are woven into the tapestry that will secure the edge. It's taken four weavers almost a year to complete. And now the tapestry is finally rolled up for the cutting off ceremony. The installation of the tapestry into the Sydney Opera House marks the end of an amazing journey. From its original conception some 50 years ago to its final realisation is a positive affirmation of what Jørn Utzon dreamed of achieving so many years ago.
It will give a marvellous feeling acoustically. It is hanging on the inside wall in front of where you have a big window facing the harbour. So from outside, even from outside, from sailboats, you will see something happens there. It is exciting and different.